So blackberry fruit do not ripen after harvest, therefore it's very important that we harvest the fruit at its optimal stage of maturity. The surface has to be completely black, and then of course we want to start that cooling process as soon as possible after harvest. Different cultivars have different quality characteristics, maybe slightly different sugar content, acidity, maybe a little different aroma. But all of this can be preserved if we cool that berry down near that 32 to 34 degrees and maintain it at that temperature all during transportation, distribution, and even in terms of the homeowner storage. One thing, blackberries, what growers do use in terms of market quality, often they have a little machine called a refractometer, and we squeeze a few drops of juice of blackberry on the refractometer prism, and that'll give us an indication of the sugar content of the blackberry. And let's just see what that sugar content is here. This is a handheld refractometer, and we're going to press the digital display, and we can see the sugar content is 10.3. That's 10.3% sugar. We do want to have at least 10%. That's a good quality, flavorful blackberry variety. If we get up there 11-12%, that's even better. But if we start getting below about 9%, then the flavor is probably not going to be quite as sweet as a lot of consumers would like. So here we are out in the different varieties and in a commercial growing operation in Breaux Bridge, and he has some excellent quality blackberries, certainly within that commercially acceptable quality range. But as a commercial grower, you want to have a few tools that are very important that give you confidence in the quality and the consistency of that berry. So having a refractometer where you can occasionally check the sugar content of the berry and know that it's 10% or higher gives you that confidence that your consumers are eating some really nice, high quality, fresh Louisiana blackberries. The other tool that's very important to have as a commercial grower would be a thermometer, because you do want to check the temperature of the blackberry. And we want to check the pulp temperature. We usually would like to have a probe thermometer where we actually insert the probe of the thermometer into the blackberry, where we can actually measure the pulp temperature. And now here we can see the reading, 80 some degrees, I believe, of that reading. So anyway, as a commercial grower, we want to have a refractometer that we can always check the quality and the sugar content of our berry for consumer acceptability, and we want to have a thermometer that we know the temperature of our storage environment so we can keep the berries within the desirable 32 to 34 degree Fahrenheit range. So a lot of different aspects are required for sustainability of a blackberry growing operation. It starts in the field from the right cultivar selection. It's also the right management practices, pruning, fertilization, irrigation. But as important as anything is following very careful harvesting and handling practices. Blackberries are extremely delicate, but if they're handled properly and if they're cooled as soon as possible after harvest, and that cold chain is maintained, certainly below 40 degrees Fahrenheit, ideally between 32 and 34, we can get up to 10 days of high quality, consistent supplies of nutritious, delicious Louisiana blackberries. They have excellent market potential. They're in demand 365 days a year. So one of the other very exciting and interesting opportunities that we have here in the fruit crop sector in Louisiana is the opportunity to extend the marketability of fresh Louisiana blackberries. Using the right cultural practices, the right selection of the right cultivars, we can start harvesting our blackberries, fresh blackberries here in Louisiana in the month of March. We probably would have to grow these things under a protected structure to have that early harvest. Harvest will continue then in open field in April and May, throughout the summer and continuing into the fall months. September, October, November, even into early December, probably inside a protected structure. So we can literally have high quality, fresh, nutritious blackberries for commercial sale and homeowner sale from March through early December. Very exciting possibilities. They do require a lot of attention to detail. They do require a lot of labor, but the market is there, the demand is there, the economic returns are there. So this is something that's very exciting. In some of these specialty crops, we have a lot of unmet market demand. Why should we be importing all of our blackberries from Mexico or from California? Literally, that's where they're all coming from. in Louisiana retail supermarkets. They're all coming from Mexico or California. Let's see what we can do to try to substitute some of these imported berries or berries from California for fresh, high quality, nutritious, delicious Louisiana blackberries. But we must pay attention to detail, and we must follow the right post-harvest management practices.